Hi, welcome to Taro Movies. Is it possible to build a tent heater only with equipment you carry around to heat a tippy tent up like this? If you want to find out if that works, please join me. To build a tent stove, I was inspired by those emergency heaters, where you take one or two flower pots, turn them around and put some tea lights beneath it. But of course, who carries some flower pots around, especially here in the mountains? So I took my cooking equipment, which I carry usually around with me, plus this cooking gate, which I stole my wife out of the kitchen. So here's the very light cooking gate from our kitchen. My outdoor cooking pot, and inside I have a wood gas stove. The gate is just for the stability on the ground. Here's my wood gas stove cooking set. Also a can or a pot with a lid. And here's the stove. And all I do with the stove is set him up like this, put him in the center of the gate, turn this cooking pot around. The wood gas stove has actually just the right size to keep the whole construction stable and the cooking pot in the right distance from the ground and from the tea lights. Of course, you can use also another construction or maybe just rocks to keep the pot from the ground away. The idea behind those emergency tea light heaters is actually to stop the candle heat from going just up and straight away and collect them here, build a kind of a heat radiation around the pots and also a kind of heat storage. This metal pot will not store any heat or much heat, so I take the lid and put it on top of it and then I fill it up with some pebbles which I collected on the way up here. The peppers, of course, they can storage some heat, but it will also take some time to heat them up. And at the night, when the candles are burned down, I don't think it will give enough heat back to heat the whole tent. So my plan is actually to put the hot or warm pebbles into a sock and put them into my sleeping bag as a heat support. The diameter of my wood gas stove and the diameter of my cooking pot are just perfect to put the candles around the wood gas stove and keep them in the right position. So later I put this tent peg here to keep the handhold from the candles away. And I have here exactly 8 tea candles. Before we go further on, there's something really important to know for your own safety and your own security you should know. I experimented a lot in my backyard before I came to this solution. And believe me, it's very important that there's a distance between the tea lights. Also that the distance between the tea lights and the pot is big enough. Otherwise, if the tea lights stay close together and the pot is too low, there will be a kind of a heat buildup, and this ends up in an explosive jet flame and a wax burn. If this happens, never put any water on the wax burn. Then you create the next explosion. Stay away or take a blanket and pull it over just to keep the oxygen away. Please remember that. Now I put this tent stove system close to the center of my tippy top. As I said, the tea lights always with a little space between them. cooking pot right over the center, then this small wire here to keep the handhold of my pot out of the candle flame, and up top the lid with the pebbles as a heat storage. So that's about it. To find out how good this improvised tent heating system really works, I have set 3 temperature measure points. One you can see in the corner over there, one in the center of my tarp tipi, and of course one outside. It's also important to have some good gloves nearby in case you drop your construction, that you can protect your hands for burning. And it's also important that you make sure that there's always enough oxygen in your tent. Maybe you have the possibility to open the top and create some smooth airflow in it, or just open from time to time the entrance a little. So about an hour before it's getting dark, we start the tent heater in there by lighting the tea lights, and after half an hour or an hour we will have a look how high the temperature difference is between the outside and the inside of the tent. The sun disappeared while I had to walk around the forest, and I can feel that the temperature is dropping down as well. So I think it's time for the first temperature check and to start the tent heater. So here's our first checkpoint, the thermometer next to the top tent, and you can see we have about 4 degrees Celsius. Now the inside, that's the thermometer in the center, and we have also about 4 degrees Celsius. Let's check the corner over there. Hope you can see that. Yes, it's the same result, 4 degrees. So let's have the first look after about 30 minutes. Now it's quite dark, and outside about 2 degrees, 3 degrees Celsius. Let's have a look right quick. Entrance again, about 8 degrees Celsius, and in the corner around 7 degrees Celsius. I try to touch the pot, and of course the pot is very, very hot. And they are also getting warmer. The moment when you come in here from the outside, where we have around 3 degrees Celsius, feels like a huge difference. Here in the center we are around 8 degrees, and over there in the corner about 7 degrees. I think it's absolute worth it to do this little effort for this tent stove. Again, please remember about my safety instructions if you try something like that. So what I'm going to do now is lay here and stay here for another hour, and let's see how my body heat, my body temperature, and my breathing affects the temperature inside, and have a last check after that. So I've been turning my
headlight off, and I have to say, next to this heater, which is really a kind of comfortable and cozy, also the candlelight in here gives it a really nice atmosphere.
So after about another 30 minutes with me inside, the rock's starting to get hot. And here we have around 13 degrees, which is about 10 degrees more than outside. And in the corner, close to 10. Of course, the efficiency of a heating system like that is depending on the size and the material of the tent and also of the ground. But you have seen, after 1.5 hours, we had a temperature difference to the outside over 10 degrees Celsius, which feels a lot after such cold conditions here in the mountains. If you want to give a system like this a try, please remember my safety instructions I told you before. I would be very happy if you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and give me a thumb up. See you in the next video. Tschüss, ciao, bye bye.